heroes to the Faculty of Economics and Management. I used to be a scientist in here. I was I graduated from here in the 2011 promotion, you know, and well, I'm someone that loves the English language, you know. I do love it from the bottom of my heart. From the very first day I stepped into the club, up to now, I still have that liking of the English language that helps me. Every time I feel down, every time I feel that, well, I would never be able to speak the English language. It's just you guys that are motivating me, because I remember all the things that I used to do in here, and, well, all the nice moments that I used to have with you, and all of the words you used to teach me, because, well, that's who I am. When you talk about Abdulrahman Tamara, you talk about a scientist, but also an English lover. People know me better as an English speaker than even a scientist. But, well, this is the way I am. This is the way I am. That's Abdulrahman Tamara. You guys can't even imagine how much it means to me. Well, it means a lot to me.
Yeah. So we said this a while, but you were saying, and some people said that English is for those who are in health. And you are a scientist and you speak English too fluently. So I want you to advise those who are in health and think that
Well, I think that people are utterly wrong, thinking that scientists will never be able to speak the English language. And I can even assert that scientists speak the English language better than even visitors nowadays. Because, well, this is something that I've noticed. Last year, here in this very place, were two guys who were scientists, the best of their promotions. But those guys had really, well, wonderful skills. Guys like Keba and Sirin Hamad, they spoke the language in a very nice way. So you guys should not believe in what people are saying. People will be gathering away whatever happens. They will be speaking, you know. Just do not care. If you love something, you got to do something. You know, even though, well, it was hard back then. It was hard being a scientist and at the same time wanting to be a member of the club. Especially taking such commitments, just like being a vice chair, was not easy at all. Because sometimes I had to play truant from courses to come in a team here in this club. And it was not easy. But I knew that I felt well that I had to do it. I had to do it because of my love. I love the language. That's the thing that was motivating me, and I want you guys to love it, to keep working on it, because, you know, English is some of the most important languages of the world, and I can even say that it's the most important language of the world, because, well, as economists, I want to be an economist, well, and, you know, economists, you know, most of them, they speak English. Most of them, even our teachers there in the faculty, they sometimes speak in English. No, sometimes you're doing some statistical or mathematical exercises and the teacher starts speaking English with you, you know. And you see, this is important. This is very important, you know, especially for scientists. If you want to be the leaders of tomorrow, if you want to lead our country ahead, you need to grasp, master this language of Shakespeare. And really, I want you guys to keep ahead and keep coming in this club. Never be ever stop coming in this club. This is the best way ever. You have a tremendous opportunity that I do not have now, and I wish I could have it, because at home I don't have anyone to talk to. Sometimes I stay home, I'm talking to my relatives in English, but they just don't understand. And it's just another waste of time, because, well, they sometimes tell me to shut the hell up, something like that, yell at me, you know. But just you guys try to grasp this opportunity that you have. It's an opportunity, so don't let it slip away.
If someone wants to know about your child, your life child. Your
childhood.
Oh,
yeah.
I mean, your
childhood. Yeah, yeah. My childhood. Well, I can tell that there's nothing special in my childhood. I was proud. Well, nothing special. Well, my childhood, I spent it in Chicago. I was, you know, a smart student because I started school very early. I was 5 when I started school, you know. I was always working. I was the first in my class, you know. But after when I came in CAM Yamagata, the junior school in the CAM Yamagata, you know, I totally changed. I was really a master, really a brat. I always was, you know, messing things up, you know, but I totally changed my teacher. But everybody kept, you know, telling me off and, you know, taking some beating us, you know. And that's me, well, when I was in back then, that's my childhood. I spent it in school, but I was doing just the nice things, you know, and having nice memories, things that I'll never forget, you know. And that's my childhood.
So short.
Your hand, please. Your best memory in this
industry. In this industry. You know, I wanted to start by, but you know, the nicest moment that I have in this, that I had in this club was with all the guys, you know. Well, it was the eve of the ELA competition. Now that day really marked me a lot. I really loved that day. Because, you know, it was a moment I spent with my guys, you know, and the cheerleader and I were those who were supposed to present our high school. So we prepared something, a little presentation that we came and performed in front of the guys, you know. So right after having performed it, you know, I could see guys cheerful. I could see guys really happy in a way. They were literally blissful in a way that I had never been before. And it was something that was tremendous that I'll never forget in my entire life. And there were even guys like Grame right here, Abu Lee, a friend of mine. He was always at the bottom. Yeah, so, well, this I can tell was the nicest day I had in this club, right?
And what about the bad days?
The bad days, the bad days, well, it was just a little bit after having failed, after having lost that ELA competition. Damn, I was too down. I even took off my shirt and threw it away. Well, I didn't want to see it again because I really thought that we'd be in something together. But, well, after in the aftermath, well, I understood that the essential was to participate. You know, although we lost, well, it was something great because we had participated. And well, I wish we won that day. But anyways, but God wants to end up with it was again. So.
And I heard that that day you have put up your season of ELA.
Yeah, I took it out.
So what? So if you are angry, that is really good.
Yeah. I remember I had a problem to control myself. You know, wherever I was angry, I was livid, you know, I slammed out of the door, you know. I was kinda crazy because, you know, I really thought from the bottom of my heart that we would win that contest. And well, especially what hurt me the most was that, you know, those guys who were debating with, because I was not aware of all the things that happened during the previous rounds, you know. I was debating. So during the debate, I noticed that guys were making elementary mistakes in speaking, and us were doing something gorgeous together in the club, you know. And then in the aftermath, when I heard that we lost, I was too down. I mean, I just didn't understand what was happening. I thought that they had cheated, you know, something like that. That's why I was out of myself, literally out of myself. You know, that's why. So,
okay, great.